Hi and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleak, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to easily apply a levels adjustment in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover working with your histogram and working with your output levels. When you're working with levels, this function is going to allow you to control the brightness, contrast, and tonal range of your selected artwork. If you want to apply this as a permanent, uneditable adjustment, just select your artwork, go into the Object menu, find Filters, Phantasm, and then choose Levels. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the Effect menu, scroll down to I find Phantasm, and then choose Levels. By going into the Effect menu, I'm going to be applying this as a live effect, which means I'll be able to make changes to this in the future if I need to. Clicking on Levels once is going to bring up the Phantasm levels for me. Over here at the top, we have this drop-down menu, so we can choose individual channels, and we even have access to the image alpha. For this tutorial, I'm going to make changes to all the channels at once. Now let's take a look at how to make some changes to the histogram. If you're not familiar with the histogram, it's basically just a graph that's going to represent your shadows, midtones, and highlights. Right over here at the top, you could enter in a specific value, or you could use these sliders at the bottom of the histogram. I'm going to bring in my highlights towards the center. Notice it's going to be updated over here in my artwork. Now I'm going to grab the shadows and make a slight adjustment in there. Now the midtones. Click and drag towards the left for this quick adjustment right over here. Now let's take a look at how to work with your output levels. When you're working with your output levels, you can enter in a specific value right in here, or you could use these black and white sliders. These sliders are going to be used to determine your black point and your white point for your particular image. Along with that, we also have our basic options. In the basic options, you have these checkboxes so you could pick and choose which elements should get these adjustments. Once you're ready, just come over here to the top, click OK. Notice over here in the appearance panel, we have this Phantasm live effect. Clicking on this link is going to allow us to make some changes to this adjustment. I'm going to deselect my artwork, and that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered working with your histogram and working with output levels. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to load and save adjustment presets in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.